You think you'd walk around remembering all the hotties, but in fact, you really remember all the uggos. Hey peeps, Trace here for DNews. When your brain sees a face, what does it do? Well, first it has to notice that it's looking at a face, and it's using bits of that face and putting them together and attempting to recognize it and gauge its level of attractiveness. From there, we decide if we want to remember that face or not. All of this happens in a split second. Most people would agree Angelina Jolie has a pretty attractive face. She has evenly spaced large eyes, full lips, and her features are properly sized and placed on her face in a generally symmetrical way, which I'm sure is the best compliment she's ever received. Obviously, attractive faces are great, but science has unexpectedly revealed our brains remember imperfect faces better than beautiful ones. The average symmetrical, attractive face is just boring to our brain. Whereas one might consider an ugly face, which really means asymmetrical with imperfections, as an easily remembered face. Something about it is novel and interesting. There's something called the von Restriff effect, which basically says our brains are better at recalling unusual things rather than ordinary things. A study in the American Journal of Psychology from 1997 found distinctive faces tend to be more easily recognized. If your friend has a scar or a mole or a misshapen eye, like poor sloth from the Goonies, then you will immediately recall who he is, more so than your twin friends who could be hard to tell apart. Another part of this is task switching. We've talked before about the brain's inability to multitask. When you're in conversation and someone you recognize but you just can't quite place walks by, what happens? You stop talking. A study in PLOS-1 from 2003 found attractive faces tend to mess this up too. When you try and sneak a look at an attractive guy in class, the brain turns off the active listening part in order to process that attractive face. A new study published in the journal Neuropsychologia found similar results to the first, but measured both recognition and attractiveness. The researchers showed attractive faces to participants and asked them to memorize them. Later, they were asked to identify which faces they'd seen before. Like in the first study, recognition got all wonky when both faces were similar, regardless if they were attractive. But the faces that we would perceive as uglier were more easily recognizable. These new results reveal our brains are finding uniqueness more memorable. An imperfect face is more likely to contain a misshapen or out of line part. So a certain kind of nose, an eye, or a mouth will set off something in our brain that serves as a cue to help us remember that face later. Though, perhaps if you're pretty and you have a beauty mark like Cindy Crawford or a piercing or a tattoo, you are now more novel and maybe that makes you easy to remember too. Science needs to look into that next. Funnily enough, there were a lot of false positives in this study. When people saw attractive people, they were more likely to say that they'd seen that face before. Simply put, we want to roll with the hotties. Do you think you remember ugly faces or attractive ones more? There's a comment box down below the video for that reason. So why don't you subscribe and then tell us what you think. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody.